Hi, I'm Diane Dayton. We're coming to you from the studios here at Lancaster Community TV, LCTV 66. And I'm here with Ashley Forsberg, mm-hmm. and you are the Central PA Walk Manager, yes. right? For Alzheimer's. Mm-hmm. And this is something we need to talk about. That's why we're here to talk to you.
Yes.
So the walk is coming up really soon. It's coming up on Saturday, September 21st at Overlook Park in Lancaster, right?
Yes, yes. So September 21st, bright and early, 9 a.m. registration, 10 a.m. opening ceremonies. We'll have 800 plus individuals who have all been affected by this terrible disease. And so we're still looking for people to come join us. You don't have to register months in advance. You can come the day of.
Yeah. And I think registration's at 9.
Yes.
And then there is a ceremony at 10.
Yes.
Right. And I think I've been there for that. There's some beautiful colors that show up out in the audience. Tell us what they stand for.
Absolutely. So the walk really is an opportunity for our community to come together. And so for us, that community is based on four types of people who have been touched by this disease. So orange is an advocate. They just want to see an end of Alzheimer's and related dementias. And then we have purple, who unfortunately is the majority of our flowers, and they represent those who've lost someone to the disease. We have yellow, who are caregivers, and then we have blue, who have the disease themselves. And so you have a beautiful garden of our community showing up together, who represent all the different types of individuals touched by this disease, and we tell their stories during the opening ceremony. And it's really an opportunity for people to know they're not alone. And then it's kind of new to us. We have a white flower. And the white flower is represented by a child typically, and it represents hope that we believe there will be a cure for this disease in our lifetime.
Yeah. And there are some treatments on the horizon,
yes.
right?
Yes. We are in the era of treatment, and it is so incredibly exciting. So 2022 and 2024, we've had two new drugs come to market that actually address the anatomical changes to the brain, the disease itself, not just the symptoms or the side effects of the disease. So it's really incredible because these drugs can actually hopefully slow down the progression or even plateau the disease, allowing people to live a fuller life longer.
Wow. So the money
yes.
that's raised through this walk does what?
Yes. So we're anticipating raising $240,000 now through the end of the year. And that money does a variety of things. So we offer care and support here locally with caregiver support groups, with individuals with the disease support groups. We offer caregiver education resources and research conferences. We also offer research itself, and part of our funding has made some of these breakthroughs possible. We have in Pennsylvania, we currently have $5 million worth of research being funded by the Alzheimer's Association through Penn State, Pitt, Temple, and some other organizations here in our state. And it's really remarkable the work that is being able to be done through the money that we provide, because we don't have to wait for Congress's approval. We see something that we believe has the opportunity to change the trajectory of this disease, we're going to fund it. And that's the difference between, you know, these private funds of the Alzheimer's Association versus kind of federal or state grants, which wow. are still necessary.
Absolutely.
Don't get me wrong. But this,
yeah.
yes, we are
yeah.
nimble.
Yeah, that's great. So you can donate, obviously, before, during, and after.
Yes, yes.
The walk, and it's a beautiful walk around mm-hmm. Overlook, isn't it?
Yeah, it's only a 1 or 2 mile walk.
Okay.
Flat, very friendly for all abilities. So we know our population, there will be a lot of wheelchairs, walkers, strollers. And so everyone is welcome and everyone is able to participate. It's very low key. There's no timing. There's nothing like that. We just want people to know they're not alone, because this disease is very isolating.
Yeah.
You know, when an individual has the disease, it changes their personality, and that can make others uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And so they start to slip away, which is heartbreaking, but it's even harder on the caregiver.
Yeah.
Because they know what's going on, and they're not only caring for their loved one, but they're doing it by themselves. And so we want this opportunity for people to come together and know that there's a whole community of people who know what you're dealing with and want to support you.
You need volunteers,
yes,
don't you?
Absolutely. Yes. So the day of the walk, We have about 100 volunteers that we're always looking for. And so if people are interested in volunteering, we would love to have them.
Okay. Doing such as?
Handing out water, handing out Promise Garden flowers, t-shirts, variety of things, but okay. nothing too strenuous.
Okay. So how do we get a hold of you for that?
Yes. So you can go to alz.org/walk and you can, you know, put in the zip code and the Lancaster Walk website will come up. And you can, you know, click volunteer.
So once again, it is on Saturday, September 21st here, Overlook Park. It's Granite Run, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? In Lancaster. And registration's 9 o'clock, ceremony 10, and the walk starts after.
Yes.
Wow. This is amazing work that you're doing.
Thank you.
And the walk is going to be a good thing.
It is. Yeah. We can't do it without our community here. So we appreciate everything that all of our supporters do to allow us to continue this work.
Thank you for what you do, and thank you for joining us and helping to find a cure.
Yes.
Yeah, thanks.